I just got a call from Bhatt Saab and he said, be fearless, be audacious and just follow your heart. And those words just kept resonating within me. And I've made a film straight from the heart with all the honesty and empathy that I could muster up from within myself. And I've managed to look inwards because of those three key words that Bhatt Saab gave me. Fearlessness, audacity and honesty. So those three words, I hope they resonate with all of you, with the collective conscience of our country, you know, which while it is asleep, so I'm hoping that this film, which is really, really special, I mean, it's about invisible people, people faceless, nameless, people who constitute such a huge majority of our urban spaces. You know, Mumbai, I was reading some census figures, 2011 census, where they said nearly 5.6 million, this is in 2011, 5.6 million of Mumbai's residents are migrants. There's a dialogue in the film which says, ke, shahar hum log chalate hai aur sawari. So it's about these people who actually run our city, they run our homes. We depend on them. So it is a story of a family stays together in these circumstances for survival, fights for survival. The only thing they have to survive is the love in their hearts, love for each other and their survival instinct, the man's primordial instinct to survive. And the film also has a thriller element, which sort of is, while it is very thrilling and very entertaining, it also is a warning to all of us. Look at these people or get ready to be bitten. And, yes, and I had these wonderful actors with me. Rajkumar Rao, my favorite actor, my muse, as people have started calling him. And I've begun to believe that he's my muse. Patra Lekha, who you saw, she, Bhatt Saab calls her the Wonder Girl from Shillong.
Along with, spelled Patra Lekha with a double A at the end.
And Manav Kaul, who you did not see in this, in these clips that we showed you, but he is again the surprise package of the film. It's a film made by an entire team, a team effort which has been made with a lot of heart. It is an adaptation of a film that we within the team have not seen, Metro Manila.
It's important that this film was seen by the original writer.
Ritesh Shah, who saw the film and adapted it.
He kind of responded to Metro Manila, and Hansal and Rajkumar and Patra Lekha did not see Metro Manila, but let me say that the emotional quotient of this film is miles ahead of Metro Manila. And what is very, very, people say that I was very brave when I made films like Jism and Murder and Raz, and it was, yes, it did take audacity to move away from this, that shrine where they were, I was supposed to be put in and imprisoned forever after Zakham, to call this great filmmaker with alternate taste. I out of choice moved away from that and made those kind of films. But it took me a lot more to courage to make in this market-driven times where the celebrity culture has taken over, where if you're not on television or not in the newspapers, you don't cease to exist. It took a lot more courage, and it was not possible without Foxstar giving his wholehearted support. And in fact, it was they who initiated this whole journey. In spite of achieving dizzying success consistently, we delivered a hat-trick. But and when you have almost made it a habit of delivering hit after hit, to dare to deconstruct yourself with a narrative like this, knowing very well the wisdom of the industry, is people don't like to be jolted out of this feeling of well-being. Anything which has got a narrative of the have-nots is something which the pleasure-seeking generation doesn't like. But the applause that spontaneously erupted from your body after the lights came on indicates that this film will be received exactly the way you received, because you are the world and the world is you. And everybody that is in the room constitutes the world. Same response was there when I saw the film alone in the editing room, when Hansal was nervously waiting outside, pacing up and down, smoking innumerable cigarettes. I clapped exactly the same way. The same response was from your colleagues from the media who are seniors and also in Delhi. So I think a good film is like fire. If you touch it, it must burn. And I think that's what Satellite is. So I feel that we have a gem of film, and that's why we, with great pride, we flaunt it to you.
And it's a very, very, it's a quintessential Indian film. It's the kind of films that we have stopped making. It is, you know, almost like a return to the films.
In fact, it reminds me of 1950, the golden era of Indian cinema, when the great Bimal Roy made Do Bigha Zameen. That image of Balraj Sahni pulling the rickshaw in the streets of Kolkata has not faded with the passage of time, in spite of so many movies coming and dazzling. Because ultimately, when the chips are down, when the dust settles, human beings are concerned about human beings. And I think the metric of success is not only the opening weekend. But what is unique about this film is that it's a very brave idea, very moving idea. It's not a festival film. It's an Indian film. It has got song. It's got the Indianness. It has the smell and the fragrance of our own people. The way Patralekha says, Rajasthan is heartbreaking. And she comes from Shillong. And she says this. That the girl from the northeast comes to the west part of the country and embraces that culture. And it's an amazing feat that we have achieved. And deconstructing ourselves when the going is really good and when you become a force to reckon with. And just when you had pigeonholed me as a filmmaker who has lost his soul and makes only movies which caters to the flesh, comes a film which has a soul and the heart. So, see it, cry with it, and realize that it takes more courage and requires brave people like Hansal and the Fox Star team to dare to do this and nudge us back into the kind of cinema that we were once known for.
It's one of the most special film in my career, as it has been one of the most challenging part for me as an actor. Like, it has drained me out completely when we were shooting City Lights. After the shoot got over, when we used to go back home, I think all of us were just quiet. Because we were all so drained out of emotion that we wanted to just go back and sleep with our thoughts about our characters. Beautiful and wonderful journey with Hansal sir again after Shahid. I think our challenge was to make this film not like Shahid, and we should not think of Shahid while making it. And for me, that was the most challenging thing as an actor, that he should not think about Shahid while looking at me performing in Salah. I don't know if I have, exceeded.
You've exceeded my expectations.
With that, I think we should just, there's this song from our film called Muskurane, sung by Arijit Singh, which is on YouTube, and it's been, it's doing really good on the social networking sites. I would request, I think we can play the song.
Thank you guys. I hope you like the trailer. It's my first film, so I have given my heart and soul to it. I don't have enough gratitude, enough. I can't thank Hansal sir enough to take me in this film. What's up? Thank you so much. Vijay sir, thank you. I can't tell you, I'm overwhelmed. I'm happy because I know I couldn't have got a better character and a better platform.
Well, thank you very much for saying what you said. I think it requires a very big heart to generously say this in a press conference. And I thank you, and I mean this very, very sincerely. Thank you very much. And thank you all for the kind of unheld back appreciation that you showed at this stage with a film like this. What made me do it? You see, my belief is that the moment you taste success, decay begins. Because it's only when you feel very comfortable, a kind of smugness creeps into you, and when you become the establishment. I had started getting the feeling that the filmmaker who made Arth Saransh, who was called the Zafan the Terrible outside on the fringes, over the years had become the establishment. In fact, there was a scene I had with my brother. It was a kind of a scene which was an emotional scene. I said, we have become the establishment. We have become everything that I hated. And I said, at this very moment, there's somebody outside, lean and hungry, who wants to make a kind of film. And I want this company to be available to that person. We need to be deconstructed. We need to move away from this sense of certainty that has suddenly seeped into this establishment. It has the stench of decay. And this was this feeling that was kind of stirring me. And it started way before it actually we delivered one hit after the other. It was, in fact, when Vijay and me were riding back from Dubai after the promotion of Jannat, and I told Vijay, I said, look, we need to reinvent ourselves, because we had almost perfected a kind of cinema which was generating numbers. And I'm glad that at that time, Vijay, knowing my thirst, feeling my kind of inclination, came up with the story. And then Hansal happened and Rajkumar Rao happened because I saw Shahid. And if that morning Rajkumar had not come with the DVD of Shahid, and I had not seen the work of these brave the filmmaker and Rajkumar, I wouldn't have perhaps dared to take a leap into City Lights. So it is the courage of Hansal Mehta and his audacity and his guerrilla economics. You see, he's making a new kind of, what makes him very dangerous, I keep on saying, he's like China. China makes products at the cost of raw material that the world purchases. So I think what makes him so deadly, that he's made such a powerful film in the economics, and you can't dare him on this wicket. So that's what was the rationale behind. Ashiqui did not indicate that. It was on the biggest hit, and it was a tearjerker, which moving film. The cinema was a four handkerchief experience. We've tasted a dizzying success there. But yes, there's always, you have to preempt decay. And it inevitably happens when you have touched the acme. And you have to have the humility to know that there are people like Patralekha in Shillong. I mean, tell me who can say that line where she asks for money. Hansal just whispered to me, sir, that line was not written in the scene. That was not part of the scene. It was the girl, while she was performing, was so immersed in the character that she said those lines. Now, I think it is, as I keep on saying, while we think that we have an eye to spot talent, there's a Rajkumar Rao who comes from Haryana. There's a Hansal Mehta who has been written off. The obituary has been written. He has gone away into Maharashtra and growing vegetables and comes back rejuvenated. So it is not there on the super highways in the opulent hotels that you will find real talent. They don't even have access. So I think it is that realization, as you rightly said, that my office now is so successful, it's become a citadel.
जो scripts आती हैं उनकी दादा थोड़ी बढ़ गई है अभी, और काफी लोग साथ में काम करना चाहते हैं. उसके अलावा life तो same है, मतलब जैसा मैं था पहले भी और अभी भी वो तो same है. वो नहीं बदला, वो बदलना भी नहीं चाहिए. Actually जब जो दीपक का character है, वो भी एक सपने के साथ आता है बॉम्बे शहर में. मैं भी एक सपने के साथ 2008 में आया था बॉम्बे, और मेरा सपना तो मैं जी रहा हूँ डेली, अभी भी सपने में ही हूँ मैं, चल रहा है. दीपक का पूरा हुआ कि नहीं हुआ वो तो हम फिल्म के बारे में.
जी, उनका नाम विनोद रावत है. तो विनोद रावत इज बेसिकली अ कास्टिंग डायरेक्टर. सो ही कॉल्ड मी अप एंड ही टोल्ड मी, सो देयर इज एन ऑडिशन, ऑल्सो एन एक्टर, ही इज ऑल्सो एन एक्टर. सो ही टोल्ड मी देयर इज एन ऑडिशन गोइंग ऑन एंड वुड यू कम एन ऑडिशन फॉर इट. So I went, I auditioned for it. I knew it is a mother's character. Then there were 2-3 rounds of auditions, and the final round was with Hansal sir. So I had come back from Calcutta because I knew I had an audition with Hansal sir. I gave the audition, and for 2 days I was just at home expecting a call from Hansal sir. Though he didn't call, in 2 days he did. And after that I just cried and I cried and I cried for the next 2 days. I couldn't believe that, you know, I had got the part. And then I went to Mahesh sir. I was really nervous. I was nervous because this character is, by then I had read the script, and it is very emotional, and it is a very heavy film to carry as a debutant. I went to his office, I'm like, sir, I'm really nervous and I don't know whether I can carry it and stuff like that. But sir gave me that one liner that cracked my character. He was like, for this woman, everything is good. Everybody is good. Nobody is gray. Nobody is black. So that really helped me crack the character. And also the other day I was talking to him, and he was like, actually, you know, you were not nervous. You were overwhelmed. You were overwhelmed because you got the part.
मेरा फिल्म में एक बहुत प्यारा मोमेंट है. उसमें कोई डायलॉग ही नहीं है. वो एक सीन है जब ये मुझे बताते हैं कि मुझे काम मिल गया है, और फिर एक विजुअल है जहाँ पे दोनों बैठ के सिर्फ रो रहे हैं. तो आई थिंक वो मोमेंट मुझे बहुत टच करता है जब भी मैं उसको देखता हूँ, क्योंकि उसमें कुछ शब्द नहीं है. बिना शब्दों के वो सब कुछ बयान कर रहा है कि कैसा फील महसूस कर रहा होगा ये आदमी कि जिसके वो अपनी बीवी से इतना प्यार करता है उसको कभी कुछ नहीं होने दिया, आज वो जाके एक बार में डांस कर बार डांस।
रूरल इंडिया से अर्बन इंडिया में हमारे जो लोग आते हैं, परिवार आते हैं, तो वो बहुत सारे टाइम जोन्स को क्रॉस करते हैं, क्योंकि वहां की तहजीब में जीने के बाद में बेपर्दा होना और अपने शोहर का की मदद करने के लिए नाचना और फिर शोहर का वो कड़वी सच्चाई को पचाना और अपनी लाचारी का को एक्सेप्ट करना, वो अपने आप में एक ऐसा नैरेटिव है जो मेट्रो मनीला में नहीं है, वो हिंदुस्तान की तहजीब में है, क्योंकि हमारे यहाँ इतने सारे हिंदुस्तान हैं जो इतने सारे टाइम जोन्स में ट्रैप्ड हैं। तो दैट इज व्हाई अ फिल्म लाइक दिस बिकम सो रेलेवेंट टू इंडिया। एंड टू आंसर दैट क्वेश्चन यू सेड सर कि जख्म के बाद में, आई थिंक आफ्टर 15 ईयर्स आई फेल्ट व्हेन आई केम आउट आई सेड this is the most powerful film that we have made in 15 years in terms of the emotional impact. The emotional quotient of this film is after Zakhm, which is autobiographical. I have not made for the last 15 years a film which is so pure and which is so intense as Hansal's.
I was in tears while I was shooting. I was completely choked up. And the cameraman came and said, "Ke sir, Rajkumar's nose is... I'm completely, you know, I'm choked up right now. I cannot ask him to stop his nose from flowing. It is his body which is reacting to that moment. And I cannot stop that. You know, I cannot do anything fake." That is the level of honesty that went into that performance. His nose was, it was flowing and it on her hair. She did not realize. She did not realize that any of that was happening. Because both of them were so overwhelmed with that moment. The husband has just broken the news and there's no exposition. Ke the husband wife explaining ki mujhe ye karna pada because of this. It's all in the unspoken words. It's all in their tears.
No, actually this is one particular scene jo I don't drink, main real life mein main peeta nahi hu. But this film mein ek scene hai jahan par bahut hi emotional scene hai aur bahut hi important scene hai film ka, jahan pe ye Deepak jo hai wo daru pee ke ghar aata hai. To maine I told him ki sir main actually, you know, I want to drink. I don't want to fake it. Wo agar उसमें अगर एक पैसे की भी फेकनेस आ गई तो सीन वर्क नहीं करेगा। तो ही सेड ओके स्टार्ट, व्हाट डू यू वांट टू हैव? आई सेड आई हैव नो आइडिया, यू टेल मी योर एक्सपीरियंस। तो वी स्टार्टेड विद वोडका, आई टुक 2-3 पैक्स और कुछ नहीं हुआ। नहीं, ये तो कुछ हो ही नहीं रहा है, मैंने अपना प्रिंसिपल भी तोड़ा, दारू भी पी और कुछ हो नहीं रहा है। आई हैड 2 मोर एंड सडनली हिट मी एंड आफ्टर 5-6 पैक्स आई वॉज गॉन। तो वो सीन ऐसा था कि वो मैं चल के आता हूँ सीढ़ियों से ऊपर कुछ 3rd फ्लोर तक। तो मेरे आसपास कुछ 7-8 लोग थे कि मैं बहुत ड्रंक था, आई हैड नो कंट्रोल ओवर माय बॉडी दैट टाइम। और वो नीचे एकदम गहरा 8th फ्लोर पे हम लोग शूट कर रहे थे 10th पे, और नीचे एकदम अगर गिरता तो नीचे जाता मैं। तो आई थिंक वो फिजिकली काफ़ी टफ रहा मेरे लिए वो सीन, क्योंकि आफ्टर पैक अप ओनली आई न्यू कि मैं कैसे, मैंने कितना निकाला और क्या रहा।
उसके लिए टफ नहीं था, हमारे लिए भी बहुत टफ था वो। मतलब हम उसको नीचे ले जाते थे, सबको धक्का मारता था कि मैं चलूँगा मैं चलूंगा वो। मतलब सीन के बाहर जो था वो सुपरमैन बन गया था। इट इज़ इंटरनल फार्मिंग। आई एम जस्ट आई यू नो आई स्लोली बिगैन टू सेल आउट बिकॉज आई रियलाइज दैट आई हैड नो मीन्स ऑफ सर्वाइवल इन दिस इंडस्ट्री। सो आई स्टार्टेड, आई मेड अ सेक्स कॉमेडी, देन आई स्टार्टेड मेकिंग, ट्राइंग टू बिल्ड सेटअप्स। आई कुड नॉट रीच आउट टू द बिगर स्टार्स, so I started finding stars who were feasible at that time, who had one good weekend. So I started finding them, started making indifferent films, and that indifference somewhere got me very, very frustrated. It got me very angry with myself. So one after my last film before Shahid, Woodstock Villa, I was really upset with myself because I felt I was not only doing injustice to myself, I was also letting down the people who entrusted me with those films. You know, I had no business making films that I did not believe in. And so I left, and then Shahid Azmi, his life touched my life, and it has transformed me as a person. I think Shahid Azmi is my, you know, angel from heaven. He changed me. An actor like Rajkumar, as my muse, because he makes my work really easy. I am able to express through him and he has the same if not more honesty. He has greater level of innocence. He is not as cynical as I can become. He's not yet cynical, and I'm really privileged that I found him at this stage in my career. I think he has transformed my film.
Actually, क्या हुआ? हम लोगों ने कैमरा कहीं दूर लगा रखा था, zoom lens लगा के, और buses actually cross हो रही थी. तो हमने 2-3 बसों को हाथ दिया, नहीं रुकी. और हमने एक बस को हाथ दिया, वो सच में रुक गई है. तो हमें लगा अरे ये तो सच में रुक गई. तो हमने कहा अब तो रुक गई है, तो हम लोग कुछ कर नहीं सकते. तो हम वाकई उसमें चढ़ गए. और इतना टाइम नहीं था कि पहले तुम चढ़ो, कि अगर वो बस वाला निकल गया तो फिर से रीटेक के लिए नई बस कहाँ से लाएंगे. तो हम वाकई वो असली की बस है, हम चढ़ गए. उसने कहा हाँ कहाँ जाना है. तो हमने कहा कि हमको अगले स्टैंड पर छोड़ देना. तो जगह टिकट लो. तो हमारे पास पैसे नहीं थे उस टाइम सच में जेब में.
पावर के लिए मतलब ये चीज़ें लोग एजेंडा अपना बनाते रहते हैं. तो वो पावर में रहने के लिए आप लोगों माइग्रेंट्स के बारे में उल्टा सीधा बोलोगे. एक वो एजेंडा अलग है. लेकिन प्रॉब्लम हम में है, जो हम इस शहर में रहते हैं वो हम इन लोगों को देखते नहीं हैं, उनके बारे में सोचते नहीं हैं. हम उनको काम देते रहते हैं, बस बाथरूम साफ़ करना, ये चोक हो गया है मेरा, कम चोक हो गया है, ठीक कर देना. लेकिन बस उसको मतलब आप मुश्किल से, जब आपको बहुत कुछ काम करवाना हो तब आपको याद आता है अरे अवधेश को बुलाओ. बाकी मतलब अवधेश क्या करता है, रहता कहाँ है, उसकी बीवी कौन है, उसके बच्चे कौन है, आपको पड़ी
इम्पोर्टेंट बात ये है, ये पर्सनल नैरेटिव है और उनके पर्सपेक्टिव से एक स्पेस को एक्सप्लोर हमने किया है. और वो एक महीने के अंदर वो सैलरी का जो एक पैसा हाथ में आ जाए, बस इतने टाइम फ्रेम में इतना कुछ घट जाता है कि वो आते हैं एक ट्रेजिक सिचुएशन से निकल कर, उम्मीद करते हैं कि यहाँ पर पता नहीं शायद एक ओएसिस है, और यहाँ पर वो पगार के लिए ही लड़ाई करता रहता है कि पगार मिल जाए बस किसी तरह. एक महीने हमने याद है फिल्म सिटी में कहा था, जब हम ये देखते थे ये औरतें फिल्म सिटी में सर पे बोझ उठा के सूखे पत्ते लेके जा, मिल जाता है इनको. ये पिछले जो हाई राइज बिल्डिंग है वहाँ पर जाके काम क्यों नहीं करती हैं. तो वहाँ पर मुझे पहले मरतबा अंसल किसी ने कहा था कि साहब महीने के बाद में पगार मिलेगी ना इनको, ये रोज का 10 रुपये जो है कहाँ से मिलेगा. तो वो रोज का 10 रुपये के चक्कर में वो महीने की जो पगार पॉसिबल है उसको देखती ही नहीं है. ये फिल्म सिटी में किसी ने कहा था. तो हमारा जो हीरो है या हीरोइन है वो उस लग्जरी में इंडल्ज नहीं कर सकते कि साहब एक जब तक एक महीने की पगार नहीं हाथ में आएगी तब तक. इसलिए उसमें एक डायलॉग है कि 15,000 महीने का मिलेगा, वो बोलता है. वो जिस अंदाज से उसने कहा है कि 15,000, तो ये आई थिंक अपने आप में एक यूनिवर्स है, एक उसकी एक लाइफ जर्नी है जो जिसमें ये फिल्म बनी.
आई मीन लेट मी मेक इट वेरी क्लियर, वी आर नॉट इन द बिजनेस ऑफ साइनिंग चेक्स. वी आर नॉट इन दैट बिजनेस. बिकॉज इफ दैट वॉज आर बिजनेस आई कैन गो टू लास वेगस एंड माई प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ मेकिंग मनी ऑन द टेबल्स देयर इज प्रोबेबली हायर. So let's make it very clear, as a studio, our business is about, and I think the challenge for us in Foxstar and what we've set for ourselves is how do we do a wide portfolio of films, which consists of big films, it consists of stars with big films, and it also has films which have huge heart in them. And it's not just about us going and buying a film. I mean, I think City Lights is a very good example where, as Bhatsav himself has said, the original idea of the script actually we brought to the table. So it is a very collaborative process. We are very clear, we want to be looked upon as a creative studio, which actually does Bang Bang, Bombay Velvet, it does Hawa Hawaii, which releases this week, it does City Lights. And we want to be involved in the process right from the beginning. And in every film that we work on, we want to be able to actually add and contribute to the film in a very significant
mention, way. That it was during our promotion of Jannat 2, and we were coming back from Dubai, and we had already finished the shooting of Raaz, that I articulated to Vijay that there is a need to move away from this idiom which we have successfully all kind of, you know, delivered on this kind of weekend, because once you touch the peak, that's when the descent will begin. And that is what my own directorial narrative said. After achieving dizzying success, there was a steep descent of mine into the quagmire of wasteland, where I made apathetic, indifferent film, where people like Hansel, who admired my film, suddenly abhorred me, till I resurrected myself with Zakham. So it was Vijay who perhaps stayed with that concern of mine. And since he was in a privileged position and he works with multiple people, he realized that here is a production house which has a person like this Mahesh Bhatt, who has these kind of inclinations and these yearnings. So this material perhaps can perhaps best be handled by him. He had innumerable other film producers who could have made City Lights into a reasonably successful film, but they required perhaps a person like me who was discontented. You know, the question is to have the eye to see a discontented Socrates, as they say amidst yourself, when you normally become a fat pig in this business after success. There's something that keeps you discontented even though you're successful. And I think Vijay had sensed that, and that is why it was his move to come with that material to me. So it is a creative marriage that we have. It's not a financier who says, ki bhaiya itna paisa diya iska humko ye de do, because that would be a very, very dead kind of a relationship. So that it is profitable because we enrich ourselves through their understanding. And they understand the ground realities from us, which they don't have access to. But they bring on the table sparkling insights, which we wouldn't perhaps have, access to without their, huge data of understanding.